Before getting into the tutorial, let's begin with the final edited outcome with AI. This video is not a Hollywood film teaser or any other movie scene. It was entirely created by us using AI with basic edits in beginner-friendly editing software. Our main goal in this video is to guide you through the basics of editing like trim, cut, crop, transitions, motion effects, color correction. Everything will be covered in this one single video. We'll also explore a couple of AI tools for generating video clips, creating a song, and even removing video backgrounds. So, don't skip any part of this video, because it's 100% designed to help you land your dream job in editing and start making money online. Now, let's proceed with downloading the video editing software. The video editor I'm going to use is Movavi, and you can download it for free using the link in the description. The reason I picked this software is that it's user-friendly for beginners. This is the video editing interface. You can easily make all your edits here. Importantly, for your edits, I've provided all the video clips used in the trailer, along with the sound effects, in the video description. So, download them and follow the steps along with me. Now, click Add Files to import all the footage. I've labeled the clips as Scene 1, Scene 2, and so on, for your convenience. If you want to create your own video clips, it's really simple. Go to ChatGPT and type a prompt like, create a video prompt for my ultra-realistic scene where King Kong and a dinosaur and fighting each other in the middle of a forest at night. The word ultra-realistic is really important here. Then, copy the prompt and paste it into Minimax AI. If you're not familiar with Minimax, it's a video generation platform, similar to OpenAI Sora, and most importantly, it's completely free. Once you paste the prompt, click here, and you'll get the results. Now, let's move to the video editor and start with the basic trim, cut, and crop. First, select all the clips by left-clicking and scrolling down without releasing the mouse button. Once all the clips are selected, left-click on one of them, hold down the mouse button, and drag it into the timeline. This way, all the clips are moved easily without needing to drag them one by one. Now, zoom into the timeline using this, and remove the unwanted portions from each clip. You can use either the split or cut option. I prefer using cut. Click on the blade icon to cut the unwanted portions. Note, use half of the third scene in the fifth scene. Split the third scene and move one half into the fifth scene. You can preview the video by moving this thin line to the right or left across the timeline. Repeat the same process for all the videos up to the 21st scene. Adjust the scenes as needed to finalize the edits. We're going to focus on editing specific scenes displayed here. Let's start with scene 7. In this scene, we'll use the chroma key feature. Now move to the editor and right-click on Scene 7. Select Video Tools and then click on Chroma Key. Click on the Brush tool and apply it to the color in the video that you want to remove. For example, if you want to eliminate the blue color, use the brush to target the areas where the blue appears in the video. Once applied, the blue color will be completely removed. To undo the applied effects, click on FX-1 and uncheck the box. This will restore the video to its original state. Scene 9, in this scene, we'll use the effects and color adjustments features. Let's start with color adjustments. Right-click on Scene 9, select Video Tools, and then click on Color Adjustments. Switch to manual mode and adjust the settings as follows. Set brightness to 50. Set contrast to 50. Now, let's proceed with the effects. Move the cursor to the right side and click on Effects Packs. Select Action Pack, then click on Overlay Effects. Search for Action 1, right-click on it, and drag it onto Scene 9 to apply the effect. I noticed some unwanted portions, so I moved the scene slightly down and made adjustments. Now it's perfect. We also need to apply effects in Scene 12. Search for Action 7, drag it onto Scene 12, and apply it. Scene 18, speed adjustment. Click on scene 18 and cut the front and back parts of the scene. Choose the center part, select the clip settings, and adjust the speed by dragging the speed point to 433%. Scene 20, background removal. Click on scene 20. Right-click, choose video tool, and select background removal. Switch to precise and click remove. Now the background is completely removed. Afterward, you can set any background you like. Scene 21, color adjustments. Click on scene 21. Right-click, choose video tool, and select color adjustments. Adjust the brightness and contrast to 30 and the saturation to 100. Now it looks perfectly cool to view. Now that all the scenes are edited, let's reverse all the clips to achieve results like this. Click the drop-down to export selected portions by moving and dragging the line, or click directly on export to save all the clips. Then, import the exported video scenes by clicking add, and drag and drop them into the timeline for editing. Click on the clip, choose clip settings, and check the reverse option. The entire video will now play in reverse. Adjust the speed to 600 to make the reversed video play faster for viewing. Let's add some text. Separate the scenes by selecting and moving with a left click of the mouse to the points where you want to insert text. Then, fill the gaps with your desired text. Move the cursor to the left side, click on title, choose cinematic, and search for Hot Steel. Drag and drop it into the editing area, then edit the names as needed. Repeat this process for all the gaps. Additionally, you can customize the text style, color, and more to suit your preferences. Let's add transitions. Click on transitions on the left side and search for fade to black. Click and drag the transition without releasing the mouse cursor and apply it between the scenes. Play the video to see how it looks. Repeat this process for all the scenes. Adding sound effects. I've provided all the sound effects in the video description. Import all the sound effects by clicking add. I have named them as scene 1 audio, scene 2 audio, and so on to make it easier to place them below the corresponding scenes. Drag and drop all the audio into the editing timeline, then position and adjust the audio clips appropriately. Now everything is complete, except for creating the background music. Let's use Suno AI for this. Use the link provided in my description to access Suno. Click Create. For example, type, generate a cinematic song for our trailer, including the destruction of buildings, burning fireballs, dinosaurs, and more, then click Create. Once the song is generated, click the play button to preview it.
Skies turning black like a curtain call. Steel jaw.
If you're satisfied with the result, click the three dots and select download. Now import the generated song into your video editor and drag and drop it onto the editing timeline. With this, our work is entirely complete. Just play and preview the final result.
Skies turning black like a curtain call. Steel giants tumble mighty, they'll fall. Roaring fireballs dance in the air. Destruction symphony.
You can also generate automatic subtitles using AI in this editor. Simply right-click on an audio file, select Audio Tools, click Auto Subtitle, choose the language, and then click Generate. However, since we didn't use an audio file with speech, subtitles couldn't be generated. You can try this feature with your own audio file. Additionally, you can use this coupon code to get a 22% discount on the annual subscription for accessing premium features in Movavi. Don't forget to use it. Best of luck!